Oh, look at the crowd.
What's the Niagara thing under the tuck and us?
We could give them one of ours.
We could give them Niagara's.
They're good sets. We'll pass one of ours.
Yeah, but we're audio, so we do it right. Kind of like Kentucky Fried.
President, Mubarak says he wants an apology. Will you give him one? Will you give him an apology?
He wants something to apologize for.
He's demanding.
Thank you. Well, it's great to be back here in Idaho again. And to be here in support of your fine Senator, Steve Symms. You know, our country is enjoying peace and prosperity, and this just didn't happen by accident. We got rid of some irresponsible policies that have been kicking around Washington for a while, and we put in a growth-oriented program in their place, and that couldn't have been done without a Republican Senate. When we got to Washington, when Steve got there to the Senate and I got there in the White House, we found that inflation was more than 12%. It's now, for the last 4 months, been 2.5%. We lowered the income tax rates by 25%, and the prime interest rate was 21.5%, and it's now down to less than half of that. And Steve Symms was a soldier in the front line of the battle that brought these things about. And that battle is still being fought. We're going to end something that's been going on for ever since World War II, and that is deficit spending, and we're going to get a hold of it once and for all. And we're going to have a tax reform that will make a tax program fairly understandable, and I think a little bit cheaper, and it'll be fair, which isn't true of the present system. And we're going to do this, and in spite of some critics to the contrary, we're going to do it at the same time we keep our military forces strong as they should be. So I know I've got to go into town. There's some people waiting there, but I just wanted to say to you, you keep Steve Symms right there in Washington where he belongs for this next Senate term. You need him, and our country needs him, and I'll guarantee you, I need him. So thank you all for coming out here. Thank you. God bless you all.
Let's go. 1976, you won a great victory in 1980. 1984, you got almost 74% of the vote in the state. I'll just be serious for just a sec. Bring him to justice. Give him a quick, fair trial. Hang him. Mr. President, seriously, all of you, our friend, my friend, the President of the United States, President Ronald Reagan.
Steve has never lost sight of the fact that what's best for Idaho is what's best for America. I know that here in Idaho, some of your key industries are still struggling. Quick fixes aren't the answer. We've had a half a century of that. We're reported with a trade policy that cuts them off from the foreign markets that are the key to a recovery for our agricultural economy. Now is not the time to be closing markets and retreating. Now is the time to let it go. Fair trade and fair trade.
Yeah. try it now.
Okay.
Right into the sun, right? Right into the sun.
Is it good enough?
Yeah. You knew that, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's go on the other side.